And just the look on the camper's face when you see them day one looking like a deer in headlights, like. But then after 5 days, 4 days, 3 days of rehearsing, you see them at the Whiskey A Go-Go and they're like, you know, their face lights up. It's truly a thrill for me to be a very, very small part of making that happen for the campers, to making that dream become a reality. And, you know, there's one thing I always tell everybody I ever meet, is that, you know, you have any words of advice for somebody in the music business trying to break into the music business? One thing I always say is that you never burn a bridge. Never burn a bridge, because I know it's cliche and said, you know, it's been said a million times before, but in 1987 I was involved with the Monkees tour, and David was involved in that, putting that tour on the road, the Monkees reunion thing. And I'm still doing, you know, talk about a gig having legs, I'm still doing a semblance of that gig now, 30 years later or whatever. Another big thrill for me in getting back or getting involved in this camp is that once I got involved in my first one, I discovered that Bruce Kulick is involved in these, and I used to play in a band called Blackjack with Bruce, with Michael Bolton and Jimmy Haslip, and it was just me and Bruce and Michael and Jimmy, and to be able to play in a simple little counselor jam with Bruce, but 30 years later after the fact, is a big thrill for me. So, part of the fantasy camp for me is a fantasy of mine to be able to play a half a song with Jack Bruce, to be able to play a half a song with Roger Daltrey, and these are like bands that I used to go see at the Fillmore East in New York when I was 13 and 14 years old, and now, you know, I'm playing Life in the Fast Lane with Joe Walsh. It's like, what's there not to like about it, you know?